mama. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Acha. Yeah. Okay. Namaste, masters. A very good morning from Melbourne. India lo aithe inka good morning. Meek inka just ippude 4:00 untundi. Tarvata different time zones nunchi join aina vallakandarki a very good day. Yesterday we had a great day. We started off at 4:00 with our great master Suresh Kumar from our platform, who wanted to enlighten us all with pranayama. So we started yesterday with the basics. How do we sit? What's the posture? Even before we get into pranayama, what are the postures? What is pranavanada? How does it help inside our body? What happens inside our lungs when we do pranavanada? Beautiful way of taking us into pranayama. I'm so happy that he has not dived us directly into breathing exercise, and he's really taking us stepwise. That shows how great he is in his area of skill, which is his yoga seva. I'm very pleased to again bring him back on this platform today. So Suresh Kumar garu, you can please again come back, and Deepthi, you can spotlight him, amma.
Yes.
So you have time till 4:30, sir. And after that, yes, our Deepthi and Shailja madam will take away. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you again for coming between us and enlightening us with the basics of pranayama. Thank you, sir.
Sir,
మీరు కొంచెం వెనక్కి వెళ్ళాలి సార్ ఇఫ్ యు గో అ లిటిల్ బిట్ బ్యాక్ దెన్ వి కెన్ సీ యువర్ ఫీట్ యాస్ వెల్ యా గుడ్ సార్ దట్స్ గుడ్ నౌ వి కెన్ సీ
వెల్ ఆన్ దిస్ very graceful morning. It is my privilege and it gives me an immense pleasure to share some concepts on yoga. Well, friends, if you are sitting on a mat, those who can take Padmasana, you go to Dandasana, you can take the Padmasana like this. Those who are not sitting on the mat, if you are sitting on a chair, no problem. Sit comfortably there. Then I take this Dhyana Mudra. This is Dhyana Mudra, or Brahma Mudra, or the Saraswati Mudra. I place the palms on the knees. We start with chanting 6 Omkaras. Gently close your eyes. Sit straight. Take a deep breath. Oh. Udgita Pranayama. It is named as Udgita Pranayama. Pranayama Japa, Omkara Tapa. Now, very recently, friends, a research was conducted by NASA. They recorded the sound emitted by the sun. Hertz, H-E-R-Z. Hertz is a system international unit which is used to measure the frequency of vibrational waves. We have the waves like electromagnetic waves, mechanical waves, and so on. This Hertz is named after German physicist J.R. Hertz. Friends, human one hertz means it is one cycle per second. 20 hertz means it is 20 cycles per second. 20,000 hertz means it is 20,000 cycles per second. Human hears can hear the sound ranging between 20 hertz and 20,000 hertz. Suppose if we take bats, B-A-T-S, bats. Bats are having an extraordinary ears. Bats can hear up to 1 lakh hertz. The sound emitted by the sun is an electromagnetic wave. Friends, we cannot hear electromagnetic waves. What NASA did? NASA recorded the sound emitted by the sun. They converted that to mechanical wave. They compressed the waves, converted to mechanical wave, and that wave they put into the audible interval between 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. Friends, when that recorded sound emitted by the sun was heard, amazingly, it is Omkara. The sun is chanting Om. The other planets of our solar system is emitting different sounds, but sun is chanting Omkara. Now, this Omkara is chanted by the sun in a particular cycle. So friends, it is Udgita Pranayama. It is the repeated chanting of Omkara. It is Udgita Pranayama. Friends, 1 billion. 1 billion is 100 crores. 1 trillion. What is 1 trillion? 1 trillion is 1 lakh crores. The sun, from how many years it is chanting Udgita Pranayama? Friends, the sun is chanting Udgita Pranayama from billions, from trillions of years. From trillions of years, the sun is chanting Udgita Pranayama. What an amazing concept. What an amazing concept. Well, Patanjali Maharshi was the father of modern yoga. Modern yoga is also called as Navina Yoga. This modern yoga or Navina Yoga is approximately 3600 years old. Now, Patanjali Maharshi did not invent yoga. Before Patanjali, thousands of years back, the yoga was there in different forms. Patanjali Maharshi assimilated it and he formed that in the form of Ashtanga Yoga and Yoga Sutras. Friends, today we shall see the Mudra Yoga. The Mudra Yoga. Now, one of the Vedic verses says, Pancha Bhutatmakam Idam Shariram. Now, this physical body is made up of 5 elements. It is made up of 5 elements. The Agni, the fire, the air, the Akasha, the cosmic, the earth. What the food we are taking is from the earth. The Jala. Jala is water. 70% of the body is composed of water. So, this body is panchabhutatmakam idam shariram. It is made of 5 elements. Friends, if we take 5 fingers, these 5 fingers represents panchabhutas. If I take the 5 fingers, now this finger is called as the thumb. Now this finger is called as the index finger. This finger is called as the middle finger. This finger is called as the ring finger, and the chota finger is called as the little finger. Now, suppose if I take the thumb represents Agni, fire element. Now, if I take the index finger represents air, Vayu. Now, suppose this is the longest finger, friends. This is the longest finger. This longest finger represents Akasha, cosmos. Now, this ring finger represents Prithvi, earth. And this chota small finger represents Jala. Jala means water. So, the 5 fingers in our palm represents 5 elements, panchabhutas. Now, suppose if I join these 4 fingers, if I take the palm like this, now, if I cup the palm like an antenna, now, friends, this is called as Abhaya Mudra. Now in Abhaya Mudra, the energy converges. In Abhaya Mudra, the energy converges. So this is Abhaya Mudra. Now, suppose if I take this, now this is Vayu Mudra. This is Vayu Mudra. Now this is Akasha Mudra. This is Akasha Mudra. This is Prithvi Mudra. Now this is Jala Mudra. This is Jala Mudra. Now suppose if I take the mudra like this. Now this is Prana Mudra. Now suppose if I put down the first two fingers like this, if I place my thumb at the root of the small finger, friends, now this mudra is called as Mrutyu Sanjeevini Mudra. This is Mrutyu Sanjeevini Mudra. Now suppose if I take this is Chin Mudra. Now if I take this is Chinmaya Mudra. Now suppose if I take the palm, if I place the thumb at the root of the small finger. Now this is Santosha Mudra, the mudra for happiness. Santosha Mudra. This is Santosha Mudra. Now if I gently close the four fingers like this, now this is Adi Mudra. Friends, every child in the womb will be in Adi Mudra. Every child in the womb will be in this Adi Mudra. Now if I place the left hand like this, if I take the left hand and place it on my lap, now on the left hand, if I place the right hand, this is Bhairava Mudra. Now suppose if I place the right hand first, on the right hand if I place the left hand, now this is Bhairavi Mudra. Now on the left hand, suppose if I take like this, now this is Shivalinga Mudra. This is Shivalinga Mudra. If I clasp my hands like this, if I place on my lap like this, now this is Yoga Mudra. This is Yoga Mudra. Now there are so many mudras. Now this is, friends, this is Namaskara Mudra, or Namaskara Mudra is also called as Pranjali Mudra. Let us see the variations. Now suppose if I take the Namaskara Mudra like this, now this is Kailasha Mudra. If I extend like this, now this is Anjali Mudra. Now with Padmasana I have taken Anjali Mudra. Now this entire posture is called as Parvatasana. Parvata means mountain. So the entire posture is Parvatasana. Now this is Anjali Mudra. This is Anjali Mudra. Now these, friends, there are thousands of Hasta Mudras. These are Hasta Mudras. Now if I take the hand, now this is the palm, this is the wrist, now this is the forearm, and this is the elbow. This is the elbow. Now here I have demonstrated the Hasta Mudras. Now even using the forearms, you can have a mudra like this. Friends, this is Hasta Garuda Mudra. This is Hasta Garuda Mudra. Now we can use the palms, fingers, even we can use the forearms for mudras. Now even we can use the tongue for a mudra. Now suppose if I protrude my tongue, if I squeal, if I form a tube like this and suck the air inside, I take the air inside, and while expelling, I expel from the left hand side, the left nostril, like this. Once again. Now this mudra is Kaki mudra, Crow mudra, Kaki mudra. Now the temperature is very high. Now if we suck the air inside by using Kaki mudra, now it is the Lee Chatelier's principle. The refrigeration effect will be there, and the temperature of the body will be drastically cooled. Now this is Kaki mudra. Kaki mudra. Now since I am expelling from the left, now the left is called as the Chandra Nadi, the right is called as Surya Nadi. Now since I am expelling from the left, it is Chandra Kaki mudra. If I expel from the right nostril, it is called as Surya Kaki mudra. So this is Chandra Kaki mudra. Take the air inside, expel from the left hand side, the left nostril, hence it is called as Chandra Kaki mudra. Now we are using the tongue.
Sir, one question. What is the difference between Chandra Nadi and Surya Nadi mudra? Any difference in temperature?
Yes, madam. Chandra is left. Now, if you take. Now, this is the Chandra Nadi, very beautiful question. This is the Chandra Nadi left. Now, in the spinal cord, we have three nerves, right? Now, from Muladhara, the left nerve, this is Chandra Nadi. Chandra Nadi is always cool, the left. Now, if I take the right is Surya Nadi. Surya Nadi is always hot, and this is the Sushumna Nadi. This is the Sushumna Nadi. So this is the Chandra Nadi, Chandra Ida, Pingala, Sushumna. This is cool. This is hot. Now this is the Brahma Nadi, Sushumna Nadi.
So if you Simha means
lion.
Sir, one second. I still have this question. When you breathe out through left one, then the temperature cools down, is it, for your body? Is that what you're saying?
Yes. That is a beautiful, that leads to Swara Yoga, madam. Your question is a beautiful question. It leads to Swara Yoga. Swara Yoga. It is a very big size. A very big size. Little later, I'll answer your question.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Later, I'll come to your question.
Thank you.
Now, Simha Garjana Mudra, lion. I protrude my tongue like this, and take the air inside. Simha Garjana Mudra. The king of mudras is Kesari Mudra. Kesari Mudra, little later we speak of Kesari Mudra. Then, now these are the basics of Mudra Yoga. There are thousands of mudras. Now I have given only the fundamental mudras. Now I have spoken about the mudras from the palms using the fingers. You can have the mudra from the forearm, like the Garuda Hastagaruda mudra. Friends, even we can have the mudras from the legs. If you have the mudras from the legs, it is called as Pada Mudra, Pada Mudras. So we have Hasta Mudras, the Pada Mudras, right? We can use the eyes, we can use the tongue. There are so many types of mudras. The king of mudras, please remember this, we discuss this later. The king of mudras is Kesari Mudra. Kesari Mudra is the king of mudras. Well, friends, now we know the basic asanas, the seven asanas which supports the meditation, and the basic mudras we know. Now we quickly recall the seven asanas and see how to sit comfortably. Sthiram, what Patanjali says, sthiram sukham asanam. Now in any sitting posture, now even if you are sitting on a chair, no problem. In any sitting posture, it should be sthiram. Sthiram means stable, without any vibrations. Sukham. Sukham means happiness. Now you should not feel unhappy. You should not have any pressure points. Sthiram sukham asanam. So quickly we recall the seven meditative postures. Now, if I come to Dandasana, friends, if I come to Dandasana, I told 70% of our Indian population cannot take Padmasana. They cannot enter Padmasana directly. So, take Ardha Padmasana. Ardha Padmasana. Now, the muscles. Now the muscles at the muscles, the knee muscles, the calf muscles, now the thigh muscles. Now this will be a little stiff. Now to have flexibility, you can flip the legs like this. Now this enhances the elasticity of all these muscles. You flip like this, then come to Dandasana, take the right leg, place it here. Now, to have the elasticity, now you can flip like this. This is Ardha Padmasana. Padmasana, if I enter from the left, it is called as Vama Padmasana. Vama means V-A-M-A. And if I enter from the right like this, it is called as Dakshina Padmasana. Right? Now after the required flexibility, you can sit in the full Padmasana. I'm entering from the left. Now this is Vama Padmasana, full Padmasana, Vama Padmasana. Now I take the Brahma Mudra, right? You can sit like this. Sthiram Sukham Asanam, and very happily, very relaxedly, you can go for deep meditation. Well, I don't know, time flashes like that, half an hour flashes like that, 2 minutes are left. Now, I chant three Omkaras, followed by Ashanti Mantra. Friends, please stand with me. Take a deep breath. Oh.
Suresh sir, thank you very much. It was a great session today. You told us about so many mudras, we can really use it in our day-to-day lives, especially that Shitala Pranayama, which you showed with that Kaki Mudra, taking air inside and leaving it with your Chandranadi, that we can really use it on day-to-day, in day-to-day life, sir. I know many people who go through hot flushes. That is a stage in life where especially women go through hot flushes. And I'm sure at that time, they really struggle how to get over that. So you have really taught us a way where if people are going through hot flushes, they can use this pranayama and cool down their bodies. This is going to be very useful. This is one thing which I thought I could add after hearing from what you are saying. It was a fantastic session, sir. I know when the session is interesting, time flies. So that shows how interesting your session was, sir. Half an hour just felt like 5 minutes. But I'm really thankful to you. Thank you for spending this time. I will talk to you personally, sir. And we will talk about our next sessions and I will let the group know. Thank you very much for today. We are very, very grateful to you for spending your early morning 4 to 4:30 with us, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Some of our participants are saying thanks to you. Thank you so much for your wonderful
session. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Dipti, madam.
Thank you, sir.
Shalaja, madam. You can take forward the meditation, but yes. Just keep in mind that we have people who cannot understand Telugu in this morning session. So like yesterday, please, if you can do parallelly in Telugu and English, because we have a big, large audience because of pranayama session. And there are non-Telugu speaking people also. So it will really help them if you do Telugu as well as English. Thank you very much, Masters.
Sure, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Definitely, ma'am.